students, today we are going to derive couple required to twist a uniform solid cylinder. We are going to find the value of couple needed to twist a uniform solid cylinder. For that we will consider a solid cylinder and it is clamped at the upper side and other side, lower side it is free. There we will attach one weight and we will apply a twisting couple. As a result, the lower side will start moving, rotating with particular angle. So this is a particular example. As I already discussed earlier, this portion AB is clamped and this portion we are going to twist. So twisting couple we will apply in this direction, but a restoring couple which is stored inside will act equally on it and it will try to bring the cylinder back to original position. So for that, consider a short cylinder of length L and radius A. Here the radius is denoted by small a. Clamp at the upper end AB. Suppose a twisting couple is applied to the face A prime B prime as shown by the arrowhead in the direction perpendicular to the length of the cylinder. The radius O prime P is twisted through an angle theta to the position O prime P prime. As you can see, it is twisted. This is making an angle phi and this is here it is making angle theta. This angle theta is known as angle of twist. Now we will see the cross section of the wire. The cross section of the wire look like this. Wire or cylinder, we just cut down the cylinder and we are seeing the cross section. So O prime is the center, then we are twisting, so this Q will go to Q prime and then it will come back to original position. This is theta, this is theta, maybe it is not visible, so I will make it little. This angle is equal to theta and this shaded, we will consider another circle. Here we are considering that this solid cylinder is consist of a large number of coaxial cylinders. We are considering it is made of so many coaxial cylinder. Coaxial means they are having the same axis, the centers they are coinciding. And here we again consider another coaxial two cylinder and the thickness of this. From this to this portion, the thickness is dx. This is equal to dx. O prime is the center. And from this to this, the radius is equal to x. And we applied twisting couple in this direction. So we will write everything. To find the value of the twisting couple, imagine the solid cylinder to consist of a large number of coaxial cylindrical shell. Coaxial cylindrical shell means if this is the cylinder, so many coaxial, it is having the same axis, same center, coaxial. The solid cylinder is made up of so many coaxial cylindrical shells. So this is the meaning of the coaxial cylindrical shell. Now consider one such cylindrical shell of radius x. See here, this is radius x and thickness dx, and the thickness of this shell is dx, cylindrical shell is dx. Each radius of the lower end of the cylinder is turned through the same angle theta, but we are going to turn the cylinder and the lower end of the cylinder is turned through the same angle theta, but the displacement is maximum at the rim, and rim means outer rim. The displacement is maximum at the rim and decreases as we move towards the center O prime, where as it moves towards the center, the angle becomes where it is reduced to zero. At the center, the value of theta is zero and it is maximum at the rim. The angle of shear represented by phi will have maximum value when x is equal to a. When x is equal to value of radius a, it has maximum value and least at O prime, that is at the center, where x equal to 0. This shows that the shearing strain is not constant throughout the cylinder. From this we can conclude that the shearing strain is not constant throughout the cylinder. It is maximum on the rim and least for the innermost layer. One more thing. Thus, angle of shear is the same for any one of the hollow cylinders being greatest for the outermost and least for the innermost cylinder. Q and Q prime, which is initially there is no Q prime, but after the application of the twisting couple, Q gets shifted to Q prime, are supposed to lie on the rim. We are considering here that Q and Q prime are lying on the rim of the hollow cylinder of radius x and phi is the angle of shear, then from the diagram which I already show you, Q prime is equal to L into phi, as phi is very small. Q into Q prime is equal to L into phi. Then Q prime is equal to L into phi, as phi is small. From this diagram, Q prime is equal to x into theta. From this diagram, Q prime, here the Q prime is lying somewhere inside. So how we found this? Sine phi is equal to sine angle is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. From that equation we got this, and moreover we replace that sine phi, because phi is very small, as we are saying that sine theta is nearly equal to theta, means we are considering those value of theta for which sine theta is nearly equal to theta. Means sine theta, when, what is the condition for sine theta to be equal to theta? That is the condition when sine 0 is equal to 0. Yani when the angle is very less, then in that condition only sine theta is nearly equal to theta. So here we are using sine phi. So sine phi is nearly equal to phi. So when phi is very small, Q prime is equal to L into phi. But at the same time, when we saw the cross-sectional area, from that we found that Q prime is equal to x times theta. So we can equate, since these two are equal, we can equate this to equation. So by equating this to equation, we will get L phi is equal to x into theta. From this equation, phi is equal to x into theta upon L. This is equation number 1. If eta is the coefficient of rigidity, then eta is equal to shearing stress divided by angle of shear, which is equal to T upon phi. So from this equation, T is equal to eta times phi. But we already got value of phi. We will substitute over here. We will get eta x theta upon L. Equation number 2. Now we are going to see the face area of this hollow cylinder. So face area of this hollow cylinder is equal to 2 pi the radius. Radius is dx into dx. So the face area of the hollow cylinder is equal to 2 pi x into dx. Now the face area of the hollow cylinder is equal to 2 pi x into dx. Therefore total shearing force on this area is equal to, shearing force is equal to 2 pi x dx into, we got shearing stress is T, so that is equal to eta x theta upon L, face area into shearing stress, 2 pi eta theta x into x, x square dx upon L. Now we see moment of the force about OO prime is equal to 2 pi is equal to 2 pi eta theta x square dx upon L as it is from this into x. Now the twisting couple applied to the whole cylinder can be obtained by integrating the above quantity from x equal to 0, because the radius, the lowest value of the distance is 0 and up to maximum value of the radius is a, hence the limit limit is from 0 to a. Hence twisting couple is equal to 2 pi eta theta 0 to a 2 pi eta theta upon L into x cube into dx. Here this is dx, means this integration will operate only on the x term. Rest of the term will act as constant. Take it outside of the integration. Hence this equation becomes 2 pi eta theta upon L 0 to a into x cube dx. This is equal to 2 pi eta theta upon L into x to the power 4 upon 4. Now the limit we are going to apply 0 to a. This is equal to 2 pi eta theta upon L a to the power 4 upon 4. 2 1s are 2 2s are. So pi eta theta a to the power 4 upon 2 L. This is the relation of couple needed to twist a uniform solid cylinder. This relation is used to find the value of rigidity by the statistical method. If in the above relation, if theta is equal to 1 radian, then twisting couple per unit angular twist, we will denote it by C, is equal to pi eta a to the power 4 upon 2L, since theta is equal to 1 radian. Very important formula, twisting couple per unit angular twist, we will denote it by C, is equal to pi eta e to the power 4 upon 2L. This twisting couple per unit angular twist of the wire or cylinder is called its modulus of torsion, or another name for this is torsional rigidity. So this twisting couple per unit angular twist of the wire or the cylinder is called its modulus of torsion or torsional rigidity. Thank you. One more conclusion is that twisting couple per unit angular twist is proportional to 4th power of the radius. Very important, it is dependent on the radius, and that to 4th power of the radius. It is inversely proportional to the length.